Welcome back, and joining us now to answer your pet questions, Dr. Kim Hammond, and our special guest, a Rhodesian Ridgeback.
A Rhodesian Ridgeback, a puppy, and
it's a puppy.
It's a puppy.
He stands about yay tall.
Yay tall, and yeah. He's tough.
What are they bred for?
You know, they're hunting dogs. They're work dogs. Yeah. And that's primarily what they are. But you know, now in the United States, they're just great dogs. They're really beautiful, fabulous, good dogs, and a good security dog too. Someone comes in your house, they're not going to mess around with a Rhodesian Ridgeback.
He has very large teeth.
He has large teeth, big paws
yes,
too.
Yes.
When he stands up, he's taller than I am.
And I suppose his woof is very impressive too.
Yeah, his bite is worse than his bark, believe me.
Okay, let's get a couple questions in here. My 10-week-old lab golden retriever puppy seems to urinate frequently. How do you know if they're urinating too much? So I guess frequently is like, what does that mean?
Yeah, well, okay, so that's exactly right. So what does that mean? It requires a little bit more questions. You know, there's a question about house training versus a sense of urgency. Mm-hmm. If dogs aren't house trained and they're just going around marking, that's different than the fact that they're just squatting and nothing's coming out. So that squatting and nothing's coming out is kind of that sense of urgency that might portend a disease process. But if they're not house trained, they're just peeing and pooping all over the house. Yeah. So, you know, it's one of those things.
But this is only 10 weeks old.
Yeah, and you go to your veterinarian, probably they're going to spay and neuter it pretty soon, and you're going to have a bunch of examinations. And through the course of seeing your veterinarian, they'll make sure there's nothing wrong. It's very rare for little puppies to have urinary problems, unless it's something congenital.
So it might be just part of the process of trying to figure out how life works.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
All right, so we'll see.
Okay.
All right, my cat won't stop scratching and biting, and she gets sores on her lower back down by the tail. Mm. I changed her food 4 times. What else can I do? What would the food have to do with it?
Probably doesn't. A lot of people think you have allergies, you know, food allergies. The first thing you do is, you know, change the food and the cat stops. Scratching. I probably would look more towards parasites like fleas. And by the way, there's a new flea product on the market called Actavil. It's made by Merck. It is a great product. It's the best product out there. And talk to your veterinarian about it. There's so many options for treating parasites on animals right now. The thing you have to remember is every year they come up with a new one that's better than some of the rest. And I would caution you very strongly not to go online, not to go to the supermarket, but contact your veterinarian because the new ones are great this year.
Okay.
Yeah.
We are out of time.
All right, Jack. Go home, buddy.
Okay. Go
see
to mama.
Ya.
There we go. See how big he is? Oh, it's just a sweetheart.
Go Ravens.
Hey, yeah, that's right. Absolutely. Thanks a lot.
Yeah,
and we'll be back with